So if you have finally decided to make a company switch, congratulations, and my today's video is going to be for you. I am going to share with you 5 steps in which you can get started with your interview journey. A little bit about me. I am a Java developer. I have a total of 5 years of experience.
I have a total of 3 years of experience. I don't know why I said 5, sorry.
And with my 5 steps, I think it'll be easier for you to embark on this journey. Okay, so let's start with first, which is the resume. So as we all know, resume is the most important document in any interview process, and that is true. So even if you don't want to make a switch, please do start making your resume. It will not go to waste whatsoever. If you just Google once, you'll get so many links which will give you great references where you could get great templates to make your resume. But one tip that I would recommend, which I actually did, is that reach out to your seniors or your peers who have already made their resume. It will give you a rough idea of what all things should be included in your resume, and you will be able to make a very basic resume with time and with experience. Start editing your resume and make it better. There are a lot of videos on the internet which will guide you on how to make great resume. The whole topic of resume building is too wide and actually beyond the scope of this video. If you would like me to cover that, please do comment down below and I will be happy to make a video about it. Now, second step is, once you have your resume, now is the time to upload it. So naukri.com and LinkedIn are very common job searching portal for employees like us. After you get your resume, the second step would be to upload them in all these platforms so that the recruiters can reach out to you according to their needs. So what happens is, every day when companies try to search for resumes for their requirements, if you do not update your profile gets buried somewhere down, and that is not good for you because a lot of people apply through these portals. Now, I know this is very obvious, but one tip that actually I did not know for half of the time that I was applying, and then my seniors actually suggested me this, and my friends too who were already giving interviews, was that to keep your profile updated, and by that I mean update it every day. Now, I know you might ask me, Astha, how do we update every day? Rose nahi cheez kahan se lane to add? What I think actually works is, you just go to your profile at Naukri and add a character or delete it or do any such small change. What I did was, I used to add a space and then save the profile. Now what you'll see is, your profile will be shown as updated with the date. So now what happens when the companies are looking for resumes for their requirement through these portals, they will favor the most recently updated profiles, and since you have made a small change, the profile would be shown as updated recently, and it will be preferred among others who might have updated a week ago or like a month ago. So this is a very useful tip. So third step is to start practicing for your interview. Now that you've made your profile, obviously you'll start applying and you'll get calls. It's now the time to start preparing. Now you'll get a lot of material again on the internet on how to answer questions like, tell me about yourself, or how did you handle this one situation. These are very common questions, and what I wanted to cover in this video is more over the technical perspective. So I will be talking about that. So the number one question from your technical perspective that would be asked a lot, at least what I saw that was asked a lot, was they would ask you to draw your project architecture. Now you might ask us, so what is project architecture? A project architecture is just like a pictorial representation of your project, what data you're taking from which application, and then how you're processing it, and what all technologies are you using while processing it, and then who are you interacting with, how users are interacting with your application. So I'll just give a small example so that you're more clear about this topic. So let's just say that you worked on a project called ABC. And let's just say that your application takes some data from another application called XYZ. This is not the application in which you work. So we'll be more focusing on ABC. Now, you'll have to mention what all technologies were you using. You can just say that here you were using anything like .NET or Java. And then for frontend, you were using Angular. And then you can make arrows like this and show what database you're using. If it's an SQL database, if it's an Oracle database, you just mention that. And then you have to show how the users are interacting with. So this is a very rough sketch that I'm making. And once you have it, go to your senior or your peer who knows more about your project and show them this diagram. Ask them how exactly is everything working out here, because they know the project more than you. They know in and out. Take help from them, make a nice project architecture diagram and cram it. Moving on, you would be knowing all the technologies that your application is using and how it is working. Just go to Google and type basic interview question. For example, your application is using SQL. So, right, basic SQL interview questions, and then you will get some technical questions that would be asked and you just go through them. So if your technical is really strong, I'm sure you can tackle all these technical questions very easily. But I think it's still nice to just go through the basic ones. So these basic questions are actually something that you would be knowing, but you forgot or, you know, haven't revised since very long time during your work hours. We highly recommend going through all the basic questions with all the technologies that your application is using. So fourth is, if you are planning to give interview and you are ending up postponing it, I would suggest to you, just take the plunge, just jump right into it. I know interviews are very scary, but if you do not start, then you would not get that experience that is actually required in your interview process. Most of the times you do not get selected in your first interview, and if you do, so that's amazing, but I think that is rare too. A lot of times you have to give a lot of interviews to get that one job that fits all the criteria that you were looking in your job. So just go and give your first interview. I will tell you, my first interview was a disaster. But I'm so glad I went and gave it once, because after that I realized I was fearing about nothing. The interviewer is just not the person, it's his job. He takes such interviews every day, like thousands of such interviews he has already taken, and he won't judge you, he won't be yelling at you. Whatever you're thinking in your mind, that is not gonna happen. This is just for learning purpose. Think of it like that and just go thinking that today, if I do not get a job, at least I'll learn something. So the fifth and the last step that I would want to cover in this video is, keep some sort of tracker. Last year when I was giving my interview, I had a small notebook. So as soon as the interview with that company was over, no matter how bad it went, I used to open that notebook and just put the date, put the company's name, and then list out all the interview questions that I was asked. How is that helpful? There are a bunch of questions that every interviewer asks. Yeah, there would be variations in the questions being asked, but when you give like 10 or 10 interviews, you will realize that there are 7-8 questions that are always asked. And if you maintain an interview question notebook like this, so on the day of your interview, just go through that notebook and all the questions that you had noted down, prepare those questions next time in a better way, and you will be surprised how many times all these questions would be repeated. Also, I would recommend having some sort of date tracker for your interviews, because once you just get into giving a lot of interviews, you get so many calls from so many companies that you will lose track of who called and what interview was scheduled when. That happened in my situation a lot of times. So as soon as I got a call and the interview was fixed on some day, I would just go and make an entry. Who called me? Name of the person, the company's name. After the interview was done, I would just rate my interview experience. So before, I used to have a notebook to keep a track of all the interview questions that were being asked, and I had a different app where I kept a track of all the interviews that were scheduled. But now that I've started using Notion, I think it's a very great way to keep track of both these things together in just one space. If you don't know what Notion is, check out this video. I have in detail spoken about this app in this video. So with that, we've reached at the end of the video, and I hope these steps would turn out to be helpful for you in some sort of way. If you have been procrastinating not giving interviews for some reason, or because you're scared or any other reason, take this as a sign from the universe that you should get right into it, because there is nothing that you cannot do. If you want a job switch, you will get it. With that, I would just say, if you like the video, please like, share, comment, subscribe. It would help me a lot. Yeah, I will see you next Wednesday, 3:30 p.m. Bye, and all the best for all of your interviews.